Hey, hi everyone. Welcome to the specialized automations. Myself Aditya, and today in this video session we'll be discussing about the reading properties file in Selenium. Okay. So there is basically several ways you can do that. I mean read the properties file. One is the get resources stream method, one is the directly fetching it from the class as a get resource method, and another one will be using the file system object. Okay. So before we proceed, I would like you to tell why we need the properties file in Selenium. Suppose we are, if you are doing some kind of data-driven testing and where you are using some kind of Excel data to fetch the data from your Excel sheet, or in case if you want to fetch data from your Oracle DB, that's fine. But in some cases, when you are checking, when you are having some particular application under test and you are something, the username, ID, a password has been common, the URL, browser parameter, all these things. Suppose take it as an example for log4j object. Okay, so in that case, we need to define properties, and we'll be using the properties file. Whatever the property we have defined, we'll be using that. So let me take you to my eclipse first. So suppose for this case, for a simple test kit, I'll be needing that URL, what about the browser, what about the user password. This is the encrypted one I'm passing. So all this parameter I'll be needing in my test. So all these things I can declare as a hard code inside my class level or the test setup level. Or you can directly pass it as a parameter, okay? Or if you are using testng, you can directly pass this as a testng parameter in your test suite. But there is another way we can do that. We can just create one simple properties file that is totally relevant to your particular application that you are currently automating. So for my cases, I have created one this configured properties file. Just what you do, just go to driver utility, whatever the package you want to create. Inside the packet, go to the new, then click on the others, after just click on the file and give name as like whatever the name you want, a.properties file, okay, a.properties. So same way we have created the configured properties file, and in the properties file I mentioned this four parameter that I'll be using in the test. The next thing you have to do after configuring all the setting all those parameter, you need to have one utility classes that will be helpful to read your properties. Okay, so let me start. Let me show you. So I've written this configuration properties file and created one utility class, the read properties file.java. Okay, so through this properties, through this class, I can read the file, and whatever the parameter I pass in the inside my properties, I can fetch it. Okay, so simple as a as the approach, I can show you that simple. This is my support test class. Okay, some of this you can fetch in the class method get URL, get browser, get password. If I run this complete classes, let me just run it. So see, simply it's passing the printing the Facebook, Chrome, and Aditya, whatever they mentioned in the config properties file. Okay, URL. Let me just scroll this one here. So printing all these things successfully. Okay, so now what I basically have done, let me show you. The first thing what you need to do in to read the properties file, you have to take two things. Like first you have to declare one properties object that I've created, protected properties object. Okay, for that you need to import this utility properties. Next you need to do the input stream. Okay, so input stream will be taking it as a whatever the path will be provided, from that path particular this resource will get stored in this inside this input object, input stream object, and I am passing that input stream object to my properties class. Okay, so what I've just done, just a properties file prop, it will be initially null, and the input stream equal to input equal to read properties file dot class. What about my class name? This is my class name. So class name dot class dot get resource. So make sure while you are doing it, get resource, so it will simply fetch the resource or where your resource has been located. Make sure when you are doing, just provide the absolute path, or if you are not providing the absolute path, make a simple hash, this slash before. Okay, so it will just try to identify it from the source class path, from your class path. For this config properties file, it has been located inside my driver package. Okay, so rest of the thing is self-explanatory, we can see. And but one more thing, you have to use the open stream method. Open stream method. Why? If you don't use the open stream method, suppose if you are not using OpenStream method, so it will tell you to create one some change the type of input URL. So what is the input stream? Now it will be taken considered as a URL object. Okay, I do not want the URL object. So make sure when you are doing this, so to get resource, it will create one URL object. Type will be URL. So to convert the URL object to the input stream, we need to use the OpenStream. So OpenStream, what it will do, it will simply convert my URL object to the input stream object. And next thing I am doing, I have taken one constructor. Inside this constructor, I am loading this properties. The initial letter is null. The properties are new properties. And inside the properties, I am loading this, whatever my input stream has been passing. This, okay. Now the for method, this is returning string value. Okay. So returning prop.getProperty. Okay. So this is the properties file. That get property, whatever the properties has been mentioned, URL, you need to exactly put the whatever you have given here, exactly you have to put the same here also. So get property URL, get property browser, user password. Okay, so the same thing I have done. Now let me do one thing, system. rp.getpass. Okay, so I also want to print the password also. Okay, also this is the method getPass. Now simply running this, it will simply print the password also. Okay, so in that we can use the properties file to read it. There is another way. If you do not want to use the get resource, there is another option like otherwise like protected input stream input get class loader, it will be returning the class loader, then get resource as a string. Okay, so I just copy paste me the same thing. Let me just comment it out. Okay, so what I have done initially, I was using that get resource from the class level only. Now we are loading the class loader from this class loader. I am getting this get resource stream. So this way, we don't need to convert it to the URL. It don't get converted to the URL object. Rather, it will be remain the same as the input stream object. Okay. So get resource stream. I am passing where my configuration is located inside the package driver utility, and inside that configuration properties config properties file. So I usually prefer this way, okay, get resource as a stream, yeah, through that get class loader. If I simply use this way, now just run it. So simply it's running fine. Okay, so we have seen that enough that how we can do the property files read through this get resource stream and get resource. Now just mark me all these things. There's another way, like second, and let me show you. System is getting hacked. Okay. Control Z. Okay. The next thing is that we'll be using this. Now, initially, what you have done. Now, in that case, will we what about the configuration properties for located? I need to provide the absolute path. Okay, so in the new file, I am providing the absolute path. So this is the absolute path I am providing. Just take another file system object, and next thing I am doing the file input stream file input the new file input stream file. So this file object is, taking care of this configuration properties where it has been located, and loading this file into my file input stream. Okay. The same thing I'm doing properties prop equal to null, and inside that constructor I'm passing prop.load properties file input. Okay, so this was I'm done using the file system object. So simply run it, and okay, that's awesome, it's working fine.
So this way we can also utilize and read the file properties file. Another way that I usually prefer while doing the singleton class object creations, I prefer this way, like we don't have to create any object of the class level, rather we will be using it as a directly. So same like whatever doing of the static file object, static file input stream, static properties file, defining the properties, new properties before the before already. And my file system object containing all the file related where my file has been located. And this for method or the starting method, I'll be accessing all the starting methods, so I don't have to create any object of the class, okay. And if any exception has been found, like IO or file not found exception, it will throw, okay. So inside that method, I'll be loading the file input stream, get a new file input stream file. I'm loading this particular file and I'm loading the file into the properties level. So property that load this particular input stream file will get loaded to the property. I'm returning the property, property that get property. So each and every string static method, I'm doing the same, okay. And yeah, little bit it will be changed, like if what it will do, we don't need this, right? Just copying this thing. Now we don't have to create any properties class object, rather that we can directly use read properties file dot get url, read properties file dot get browser, read properties file dot get user. It probably is for the get password. See, this is pretty much simple. Okay, the password has not been configured, I guess. Let me delete it. See, only three methods I have created, static three methods. That's why. Let me just quickly run it. Sorry, not this one. Awesome. So see, the same thing what you have done using the static class object, static method. And we'll the file system output for all the things are static. And for singleton design pattern, we'll be using this way. What is the explanation? I mean, how? What is the use of it? Okay, I mean, why we have use it? Just let me show you in the driver singleton class object what I've done basically. See, I'm passing the configurations that here. We can see the read properties file dot get browser that I'm passing. Comparing skip this configuration dot browser, this is a separate class, but you can directly pass it this way, okay. Read properties file dot get browser. So read properties file dot get browser, what it will return? Get browser. So get browser, it will return the Chrome, the same thing I was doing inside that. Read properties for the get browser, it will return Chrome. So I can directly pass it to my driver instances, and we can also pass it to my driver in my test script also, okay. Like for test script level, let me show you, like for so we can also do that. Driver instance navigate read properties file dot get url, okay. So properties file, to this properties file we can directly get the url. And what is the url? That I've already checked, that if you do it get url, it will be paste the url. URL is given as a this facebook.com, okay. So in case of your test script level, you can also do that by utilizing this utility class it properties style, okay. So guys, as of now you have seen, that's how you can achieve the how you can configure the properties file, and we can read it through different way. Like one is the get class or dot get resource stream, another one is the dot class or get resource, and it will be open as a url type object, so we need to convert it to the input stream by that OpenStream method. Next thing what I have done, we are using as a file system object and passing it. And for singleton class user, in that case of design pattern, we will be using all the static instance class fields, variables, and as well as all the method will be static, okay. So that's all for today guys, and this is how we can read the configurations for any application properties for in Selenium as well as in Java. So still guys, if you have any questions, please do let me know in the below comment section. So I'll be happy to help you on that, okay. And if you like this video, please help to support and subscribe this video as much as you can, okay. So thanks guys, thank you for watching.